Let's evaluate our next limit as x approaches 3 of square root of 2x plus 10 minus 4 divided by 5 minus the square root of 5x plus 10. So our first attempt is to plug in 3 for x. So the numerator, 2 times 3 is 6 plus 10. We have square root of 16 minus 4. In the denominator, we have 5 minus 5 times 3 is 15 plus 10 is 25. 5 minus the square root of 25, which is 0 over 0. This is an indeterminate form, and we must algebraically manipulate the quotient to get rid of the cause of 0 over 0, and that would hopefully lead us to the right answer. The way to do that is to multiply both the numerator and denominator by their respective conjugates. The conjugate of the numerator would be square root of 2x plus 10 plus 4. Of course, we have to divide it by itself so as not to change the problem. So square root of 2x plus 10 plus 4. And then the conjugate of the denominator is 5 plus the square root of 5x plus 10. And again, we have to divide it by itself. So in the denominator, we put 5 plus the square root of 5x plus 10. Now, we're going to multiply the numerator, the original numerator, by its conjugate, and the original denominator by its conjugate. And the remaining two pieces, which is this one that I'm circling in the denominator and the one I'm circling here in the numerator, will just go along for the ride. Once we cancel the cause of 0 over 0, or eliminate it, we'll be able to compute the limit. So this is limit x approaches 3, the product of two conjugates in the numerator, and you should always put this in parentheses, square root will be gone, leaving us with 2x plus 10. Minus negative 4 times positive 4, which is 16. The product of the two conjugates in the denominator, 5 times 5, 25, minus what was inside the radical, again, put that in parentheses, 5x plus 10. And then times the two pieces that were not used, 5 plus the square root of 5x plus 10 from the numerator, divided by square root of 2x plus 10 plus 4 from the denominator. And this is equal to limit as x approaches 3. Let's clean up this part that I'm circling right here. 2x plus 10 minus 16 is 2x minus 6, which we can write as 2 times x minus 3. And then the denominator, 25 minus 10 is 15, minus 5x, 15 minus 5x, we can factor out a 5, and that leaves us with 3 minus x, times 5 plus the square root of 5x plus 10, divided by the square root of 2x plus 10 plus 4. Now, the next step is to realize that x minus 3 divided by 3 minus x is the same as x minus 3 divided by minus x minus 3. We can just send this minus in the denominator and see that we get 3 minus x. So these cancel, leaving us with minus 1. So here's what we're left to evaluate. Limit x approaches 3. We had 2 divided by 5 and then x minus 3 times 3 minus x. That's minus 2 fifths times 5 plus the square root of 5x plus 10 divided by the square root of 2x plus 10 plus 4. We can now safely plug in 3 for x, and this is equal to minus 2 fifths, and we have 5 plus 5, which is 10 in the numerator, divided by 4 plus 4, which is 8 in the denominator. All we have to do is simplify this. Minus 2 fifths times 10 over 8. These cancel here, we get a 2. These cancel here, we get a 4. 2 over 4 is 1 half, and then the minus, so the final answer is minus 1 half.